So now, if you want to understand the Ramayana, there could be various levels in this. These levels I've talked based on two things. One is Madhvacharya talks about this in his Brahma Sutra Bhashya, and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur talks about this in his Krishna Samhita as well as Chaitanya Shikshamrita. So let's look at these levels. So at the literal level, we just enjoy the story, and that's entertaining. So many people may read Ramayana, maybe some comics like Amar Chitra Katha, or they may watch some enacted movies or animated movies. Okay, it is good story, nice entertainment. Then the Ramayana can also be understood at the ethical level. Ethical level is where we learn how to act ethically. Okay, this action, now what Kaikeyi did in demanding, Kaikeyi got influenced by Mantara and she devastated her family. Now we have to be very careful about who we get influenced by. So that is, we learn some ethical lessons. How Sita was so faithful that when Ram had to go to the forest, she insisted, I'll go with you. When Bharata was offered the kingdom, he refused to take the kingdom. He sat he didn't sit on the crown. He kept Lord Ram's footsteps on the crown. This is selflessness. So we can learn various values. So when we approach the epics at the ethical level, there is edification. We learn. We get some uplifting lessons from this. Now, when we approach the epics at the metaphorical level, then we see universal principles in action in the epic. So, for example, now Ravana is a historical person. At the same time, Ravana also represents the selfish, exploitative desires, the lust within our hearts. So now, often, for people who are more intellectually oriented, the metaphorical meaning is, it gives them some either some titillation or some inspiration also. Hey, that's interesting. I didn't know that. That makes it relevant. Oh, I want to go deeper into this. Now, often, those who give metaphorical explanations, they think that we are wiser and we are going deeper than the literal. These people are literalists. They just hear the story, but we go deeper, we analyze, we look at the symbolism. So that's true. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, what he does is, he also gives metaphorical explanations of, say, the demons in Krishna Leela. But then he says that actually there is a level beyond the metaphorical also. And that is the transcendental level. The transcendental level, we understand this is Krishna himself. This is the Supreme Lord. And these are the pastimes where there are loving exchanges between the Lord and his devotees. And by hearing these pastimes, we can also develop love. And we then hear at this level, the Leela is not just for entertainment, it is for being entered into, it is for enlightenment. We become elevated and liberated.